Hello all, welcome to Introduction to Wireless Communication System. In this class, we are going to see a brief information about communication system and what is wireless communication system, what are the different types of communication systems and how the operation take place. Okay, so first we will see a communication system. A communication system is that we use to communicate from one place to another place. So like there will be signals will be there and different kind of data will be there, like you're transferring an image from one place to another. So it's kind of communication, landline phone, so it comes under communication system. Now what is wireless communication system? This landline phone comes under wired communication, whereas in wireless communication cell phones are there, satellites are there. You can see with an example, nowadays you can see around yourself that wireless communication is taking a very huge role. You are having cell phones, and other than that you are having speakers, wireless mouse, keyboard, remote control, satellites. So this all comes under wireless communication system. Now we'll go to the next slide. In this slide you can see how the evolution of mobile radio communication take place. So it all started in 1934 when the police radio uses conventional AM mobile communication system. In 35, Edwin Armstrong demonstrated frequency modulation. So as the year increases, there is an improvement in the wireless communication, and slowly in 1991, there is an introduction of global system for mobile, that is called GSM. Okay, and as well as TDMA and GMSK. TDMA is time division multiplexing. So as the year increasing, there is an improvement in the wireless communication technology. People nowadays mostly use GSM mobiles other than CDMA. Let's see the other slide. Now example of mobile radio system. What are the examples of mobile radio system? Like cordless phone are there. Cordless phone which are used in home, that is called indoor cordless system, and which are used outside are called outdoor cordless phone. And the second was remote control. Remote control is like DVD player, TV remote control. And handheld walkie-talkies. The walkie-talkies are there which are set to at a certain frequency. Only in that frequency it can be accessed. Pagers. Pagers were very famous in the 1990s, as it was used to send a detailed message. Not a very large, huge message, but only a detailed message. And after that, cellular telephones, like you're having iPhone, Nokia, Samsung, and after that you're having wireless LAN. Nowadays mostly people are using 3G dongles. In India, the Airtel is providing, Photon is there, Tata Photon. So these 3G dongles are there which can use for wireless LAN. And what is the meaning of mobile and a radio? Any radio terminal that could be moved during operation, means like a radio terminal is there, means like a talking device or communication device which can be used from one place to another, and it is a portable handheld and used at walking speed. At walking speed also you can access. Subscribers. For each communication device there is a subscriber in mobile and portable user. So each phone is given with a unique number, and they are the subscribers of the mobile carrier. So they are used with a different unique number. Now let's go with the other slide. Now in this slide we are going to see classification of mobile radio transmission system. There are basically three types of classification: simplex, half duplex and full duplex. Simplex is like communication only in one direction. For example, radio is there. If we are using radio, it's only a simplex, because from the sender to the receiver, it can't go from receiver to the sender. Okay, so that's called as a simplex. This radios are there, TV is also there, it's a kind of a simplex, only in one direction, specified direction. And the next is half duplex, means same radio channels for both transmission and reception. in this one, transmission is also there, reception is out there, but at a certain limit. Means like only one operation take place at a time. If transmission is taking, only transmission will take place. If reception is going to take place, only reception will take place. So it's called as a half duplex. But if you want to use both transmission and reception simultaneously, then you should go for full duplex. As you can see here, this is full duplex. In full duplex, both simultaneously radio transmission and reception take place. Going with the next point, that is frequency division duplexing uses two radio channels. In the frequency division, they are going to use two channels, that is forward and the one is reverse. If you are going from base station to the mobile, then it is a forward channel, and from mobile to the again base station, it is a reverse channel. Okay, this one. And in time division duplex sharing, a single radio channel in a time, because it is a time, and that one is a frequency. These are the both type, FDMA, TDMA, frequency, and this is time division. In time division, you can share a single radio channel in a time. In a single time, you can use it simultaneously. So this is the reverse channel and this is the forward channel. So reverse channel is used in the frequency 824 to 849 megahertz, whereas forward channel use frequency 869 to 894. Why? Because there shouldn't be any collaboration between them, because if any collaboration take place, then the channel won't be clear. So reverse channel from mobile to base station, it will use this frequency 824 to 849 megahertz, and from base station to mobile 869 to 894 megahertz. So the channel numbers and so the channel frequency. Channels 800 to 918 are induced, showing in this one. And the paging system. Paging system was very famous in 90s. So we'll see what is this one. It's a conventional paging system. Send brief messages to a subscriber. And modern paging system is like news, headlines, stock quotation, facts. This is all kind of modern paging system. And it simultaneously broadcasts paging messages from each base station. And large transmission power to cover wide area. To cover wide area, we should have large transmission power. So here below is the block diagram of how the paging system takes place. Here's the PSTN, public switching network, and this is the telephone, and this is a paging control center. Here you will give a message, and from here it will give you the specified paging terminals, and if he's in the required area, then it will be in a local area, then you will get the message. But if he's somewhere else, then again it will take place from the satellite to the other places where the wire network is not connected, and from again it will cross check that one, whether the subscriber is available in that area, and then it will deliver the message, the required message. So this is how paging system used to work. Going to the next slide, cordless telephone system. Cordless telephone system, they are having two generation, one is for the home use and another from the outdoor. And cordless telephone systems are full duplex, as we have seen that what is full duplex, that simultaneously both will take place, transmission and receiver. So this comes under full duplex. Cordless first generation cordless phone was in use, and the communication to dedicated base unit only, it can't go to any everywhere. And the range the cordless system or cordless phone will work is a few tens of meter. It's a 10 meters, it will come to 10 to 20 meters. So this is for indoor. You have to again set up a small base transmitter so that your cordless phone will receive the required signal. This is the first generation. And the second generation cordless phone, you can use outdoor also, you can take it from anywhere. As you can see, walkies are there, so you can use it anywhere. And it is a combined with paging system, you will also get message in that one. What are the small brief messages you can see, and it will cover a very wide area, a few hundred of meters per station. It will come only 10 to 20 meters, but it will come 100 meters. In a city you can easily roam using cordless system. Next slide. In this one we'll see how the cellular telephone system works. That provide connection to the PSTN for any user location within the radio range of the system. Means it is giving a number, and if it is available in the required range, then it can give service. Characteristics are: large number of users are there, we can use large cover, large geographic area, and limited frequency spectrums are there, like 2G, 3G, and you can reuse of radio frequency by the concept of cell. You can use with the concept of cell. You will see what cell is. Cell is nothing but you can see the hexagonal design. This each one is cell. This each and every one is a cell. It will cover a required area, and the all complete geographical area is divided into cell. Why cells are used? Because you can easily locate the receiver, and you can easily locate where the receiver is going from one cell to another cell. You can tell him the required area, that where he is located. So these cells are used and can easily helpful for the transmission of data. So they are having limited frequency spectrum for each cell, but they are having, you can use, you reuse their cells. Okay, now let's see what are the basic modules of the cellular telephone system. Basic cellular system covers mobile station, base station, and mobile switching center. Okay, now next slide. In this one you can see the communication between the base station and mobile is defined by the standard common air interface, CAI, that is forward voice channel, voice transmission from base station to the mobile, reverse voice channel, voice transmission from mobile to the base station, and forward control channel, initiating mobile call for base station to mobile. Okay, it will initiate if someone is calling to the mobile phone, then from the base station this forward control channel will take place. And if anyone is calling from mobile to the base station, then that's called as a reverse control channel. Okay, and it is initiating call between from mobile to base station. So this is the end of slide. If you like the video, please click like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.